Parker's Crossroads. This is a very straightforward battle, and the only thing to be aware of is that the enemy can show up with really good weapons. So you want to go into this battle with good weapons. You're going to have a numerical superiority. In this battle, I get almost 7-1. And the way you do that is in the opening phase, the enemy is going to attack you, and you just kind of form a circle of units around the supply wagons. And don't worry about holding the victory location. Just worry about basically just fighting and inflicting as many losses as possible on the enemy. And then when your reinforcements come in, then what I do is I focus on, in my mind, I'm going to destroy all the units on the left side of the map, because that's where his artillery is, and then I'm going to destroy all the enemies on the right side of the map. So anyway, when my reinforcements come in, I'm going to have a really good, really overpowering army, and this is going to be, you know, very lopsided. I'm going to use the creek to my advantage, and notice how I don't really care about the flag. Really doesn't matter very much. So what he's going to do is he's going to do a lot of hit-and-run attacks. And again, the biggest thing is the enemy can come in with really good weapons. I've fought this battle before where all of the enemy infantry had a lot of experience, and they all had Harper's Ferries. So you can face a pretty tough little army here, but if you come in with good weapons and if you come in with good units, this is a pretty easy victory. And it sets you up for getting a lot of good weapons for Stone's River, which is a really cool battle coming up after this one. So anyway, there's not much to this. The enemy will attack, and I will defend. My reinforcements come in, then I'll run him down and destroy him. And that's basically the rest of the battle. Hope you enjoy it. Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah.